trying to lead their team to victory. It's Brady's Patriots going up against Ryan's Falcons. With that, let's send you to Atlanta now, where Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis are on the call.
Larry, in what is scheduled to be its final season as an NFL stadium, there's a look at the Georgia Dome here in Atlanta. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the New England Patriots and the Atlanta Falcons. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22.
There's so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day. Get the blocker away and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
And finding the tight end Hooper. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come up and put a hit on him, do they?
And the catch is made by Justin Hardy. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
That looked like a pretty good rack combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. Going up top. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, 46 yards. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Now Matt Bryant on for the point after. It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. After the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. First carry for LeGarrette Blount. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
And LeGarrette Blount just does not go down easy. You know, from my experience as a defensive back, this was a difficult guy to try and tackle because of the force that he runs with, and he's not going to be daunted no matter if it's the first quarter or the fourth quarter, Brandon.
Well, what shocks me about last year, 18 touchdowns. I mean, the yards were pretty good, 1161. But when I think of New England, I don't think of a running back getting 18 touchdowns.
You know, that, to me, it was the combo that made the 2016 season for him. Most yards in his career, most touchdowns in his career by far. And he's the type of guy that, hey, you want to give it to me inside the five? He doesn't believe anyone's going to stop him.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
So the offense has it first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And
a break, one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
On 2nd down, here's Brady. And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. And he lost the football. I'll call it luck or skill, whatever the case is. They're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, 5th in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each and every week is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
LeGarrette Blount was the intended target, and now it's 3rd down. Let's discuss this offense now, and Julian Edelman, very good player,
has really developed into a terrific slot receiver, and a lot of times he would be the primary receiver. Still mad, coming out of college, that he's not a quarterback in the NFL. He takes it out on the opposing defenses.
Now Brady, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Danny Amendola, the man he was trying to get it to. Now 4th down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Now look at this, 4th and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. They'll go for it. It's Brady. And Amendola with a catch. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
And they pick up the 1st down on a 4th down play. I don't know if the defense relaxed because they thought maybe they'd stopped him on 3rd down, or if they just didn't protect the sticks very well. But, boy, that's a big-time pickup right there.
And now a 1st down following that long gain. Brady gives now to Blount, and he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Brady to throw on 2nd down. This will be caught at about the 5. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number 2. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to bring up a 4th and goal.
Okay, offense, you're getting down close, but it's still just the 2nd quarter. I say take the 3 points. Plenty of game left to play.
No movement from the field goal unit. They've got 4 full yards to go here on 4th and goal to hit pay dirt, but they're going to go for it. Brady to throw for it on 4th down. As a man, and it's Edelman for the Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman from 3 yards out. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. But he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. And after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
I know it's easy to kind of shrug off a blocked extra point, but this game is shaping up to be a tight one. The 2nd half, this could prove crucial.
Yeah, we might look back on this one. We'll have to wait and see. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Now Ryan on first down. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Falcons! Julio Jones, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Falcons are able to show off their quick strike ability. Yeah, he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Here come the Patriots again on offense, the Super Bowl champions. And boy, they have been able to do it a lot of times, Charles, with unsung heroes, haven't they? Look at the names that led them through the playoffs. Hogan, White, Lewis, guys you just wouldn't think of.
Yeah, Deion Lewis, a fifth-round pick, three touchdowns against Houston in the divisional round. Chris Hogan, undrafted. He ends up having 180 yards in receptions, including five plays of 20 yards or more against the Pittsburgh Steelers. And how about James White, a fourth-round pick out of Wisconsin? Think about who he played.
Trying to squeeze it into Edelman, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. The way he roared up and made that play, that tells me that he spent a lot of time in the film room analyzing what this offense does, and he saw something that convinced him he didn't have to worry about the pass. He could just go right now and make a play. I think if you're the offensive team, you better file that away a little bit. Maybe think about some play action down the road. You might catch him deep.
On second down, here's Ryan. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Falcons will extend their lead. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-6.
Hey, whatever you do, don't quit. I'm broadcasting this live on YouTube.
And you can bet. Hunter preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. New England comes out here to take the field on offense. You know, this is such an interesting story how they've been able to do it year after year after year. Guys talk about parity in the NFL. Well, New England has kind of transcended that parity, and they've done it with guys that you don't normally think of as household names. The parts keep changing from the middle. That's an amazing part of the process, right? The offensive linemen change, receivers change, running backs change. We know the one constant is Tom Brady. And that's a huge deal for them. To be able to do it in what you call the parity times and exactly what it's supposed to be for you. New England still top 10 offense year in and year out in 2016. And they have helped them win their defense. I like the most of those stuff. I like that they took a shot down the field with a ball cover and he's able to get a hand in and not get away. Second down, it's Brady. And complete on the right side of the field. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
The strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one for the quarterback. Who's usually going to win that?
The tight end right there.
Not in this situation. How about the quarterback beating that logic?
Make that catch. And he's here. It's first down, too. Simply be looking to build up the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Well, confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can get back out there and get it done again. But not one
taken down. Shane McClellan charging hard for that outside linebacker spot. He gets in to drop it for a loss of 12. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Play clock winding down. The throw is Ryan. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Charge the ball free and brings up third down.
You know, it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes where people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have, and a pass he should have caught.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. Third and long, it's Ryan. He's going to run for one deep left side.
Trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
finna quit. As you said, folks, the score is 6-35. That nigga was whooping his ass. Then that nigga want to blitz. When you blitz, nigga, I'm going to have Julio to go out there. Boy, look at that. 88.8 cents. 246 yards. 4 touchdowns.